Take this A, I'm gonna, instead of keeping it open, I'm gonna bar it like this. Okay, so the bass is just on the A bass, just so like this. And that's the A chord there. The thumb is gonna be on the bass, and the first three fingers are gonna be playing the three notes of the chord. So just for on the G here from the second or fourth fret, then slide like this. And that's the on the fifth fret on the B string, that's going to be an E, and then a C sharp on the G here. I'm going to add this now. Again. So when you get to, you're going to come back down to these two notes, and then a little hammer on from the second to the fourth fret on the G here. For the next part, instead of going with the A bass, it's gonna be. This part again was. That's the second part. So that just repeats itself. So there are a lot of different, again, variations you can do in there. Next part, melody is going to be on the B here, the B string, second fret. Now, because this is not a steel string, I'm not going to could bend it, but I just probably go like this on the nylon string. So that's going to be with the A bass on this note. So you're going to go back into the same initial bass. You're going to start it on this note here when you get to the fourth fret. So Do it again. Okay, so start, put that, okay, so put that together. So put it together. So that's a same hammer-on on the G, second or fourth. So it's just the E here, but I'm playing it, instead of just playing it open, I'm playing it in the fifth fret on the B. Okay, so except the second part of the bass, I'll do this again. Didn't do that last time. So after I do the bass like this, then I'm gonna do that, and I'm just gonna alternate those bass lines from bar to bar, or from the first few bars to the next few bars. So it's gonna be like this. Take the D major chord for the next part. Instead of playing it open like that, I'm just going to bar these three strings, and I'm going to play the bass. Now the thumb is going to be on the bass, and then the first three fingers are going to be on the three strings of the chord. And for that part, I'm just going to be playing the first part of the chord, the three fingers for the melody, and then just the first two notes. So like this. That's just a second or fourth, or you can do this one too. So this position here, this interval here, which is in the A major chord position, which is the C sharp here, it's sixth fret on the G and fifth fret on the E, which is an A. You're gonna just keep this position for all of them, same thing when you go to E. To D. So they're the same positions for A, E, and D. Then to E. Now, that might be tough if you don't have a cutaway to play. You could play it down here. It's still the same position. So it'll be like, so you could play it like that, but I'm gonna play it up here for now. So again like that. Coming out of the E here, slide from the third fret into this position on the G. So that's quicker. Now you have to go. If you're singing with it, then you can just maintain. You don't actually have to do that. Do that, but if you want to play the melody, you've got to get here quicker. So like this. So it's gonna just kind of practice that. Then you're gonna go right into the E, but it's gonna have the bass. Next part is difficult. So you gotta jump from there right up to the 9th fret. Then you're going to be on these two notes, on the D and the G, and hammer on the D string from the 9th fret to the 11th fret. Then you got to jump to the 12th fret here. Like that. Then you have to jump from the 12th fret back into the... to get the melody in. That's kind of how the melody is going to go. It's going to be like this. In the same position as when you play all three notes. Hammer onto the 7th fret on the E string. And then just these two notes on the 7th fret. So. Play them both at the same time together, and then